All right, everybody, welcome back. We got a new product that we want to show you. It's the ALLPOWERS portable power station, model R600. This is a little portable battery powered station that provides several different outputs of power. You have 12 volt cigarette lighter power, 120 pure sine wave inverter, USB-C, USB-A. There's a wireless charger on top there. Also a light. On the right side of the unit, you have an area that allows you to have your charging inputs and a small fuse. The main source of power going in is a 120 plug. That's a standard monitor plug or computer tower plug with no brick needed. You have a thermal breaker there, push to reset, and an XT60, if I'm wrong, correct me in the comments, to MC4 connector. And that's how you can charge the unit when you deplete the battery. On the side there is 12 to 60 volts or 8.8 amps max of solar, which comes out to about 220 watts or so. It does come with a small accessory bag. Again, this is your power cord, no brick needed, so it's internal in there. And this is your solar MC4 hookup to XT60, I believe. Let's see. XT60. So you get a decent amount of cord there. It's a few feet. So you get the box, this little pack, a cord, and the warranty card. And the QR code comes with this little warranty booklet and then your manual. So there's not much in the manual. I mean, we can flip through it. But it's pretty self-explanatory here. We're just gonna look at the front of this real quick. Again, we have a light there. You have USB-C, that's only an output. So 100 watts going out, you cannot charge with this, so it's not bi-directional. USB-A, 18 watts out, we did test that, and that will put out over 3 amps. Out of those, so it definitely works. That's a pure sine wave inverter, 12 volt cigarette lighter, and the wireless output. So what we can do here is show you guys that this is actually a pure sine wave. We have a meter and we're gonna hook it up on here. All right, so we have the power inverter on. We have it hooked to the Fluke 393. And if you see there, 60.2 hertz at 111.4. So this is a pure sine wave output. All right, the R600 is Bluetooth enabled. I'm gonna go ahead and connect it. And you should see your model right there. It's connecting now. All right. There it is. You can control everything from here, and it's a little more detailed. It gives you some more definitive times on there instead of just the 3 days up here. It says 3 days. Down here, 3 days, 4 hours. So you get a little more info in the app. You can control everything from the app, turn on and off. See that? Turns it on and off. The DC ports are on, the LED light. Let me turn the light on. But you have three dots up here where you can go in. In this now, you can turn it on economy mode. And this will shut everything down after about an hour. You put eco mode on and right there. Also here, you have the three modes of charging, which is mute mode means the fan's not really going to come on. Standard mode is what it's normally on. And then fast mode allows the most amperage to come in. And you can charge from solar and house power at the same time. All right, we're going to test this thing out, charging up some Ryobi batteries. As you can see here, we got 2 3-amp-hour batteries that are flat out. I'm gonna go ahead and get one of them on here. It is charging there. And we'll see the output here in a second. Pick up 24 watts. We are also going to go ahead and charge this iPhone. It's at about 20% on the wireless charger on the top as well. We'll come back in a little while. It's about 2:30, so we'll see how long this thing takes to charge. All right, not so bad. About 44% left. The iPhone charged from about 20% to 91%, using it in between. We charged up a lithium battery. This is a 4 amp hour and a 3 amp hour regular one, almost full as well. So about 60% would charge up two Ryobi batteries, one lithium, one regular, and an iPhone. Not bad at all. All right, everybody, we got a little setup going on here. We got all the USB ports filled in. We have a meter here that's gonna show us the true hertz. We have a laptop and a diffuser hooked up there. We have a dehumidifier, a small electric cooler, and a LED TV hooked up. So we're gonna be able to test to see if this thing has the uninterrupted power source as well as charging all of these things. We also have the app pulled up here. We're just gonna test this out real quick and see, and we also have something charging on the wireless pad. So everything is in use right now. We're gonna go ahead and turn on the AC power first. All right, the dehumidifier turned on. All right, as you can see there, TV and everything's on. And again, we have it plugged in, so this is simulating that it's gonna turn into a uninterrupted power source. We're gonna go ahead and turn on the USB-C and everything else. The laptop is charging. You see that we're drawing out a good amount of wattage now. The wireless charger's going, so everything is charging now the way it's supposed to be. And we'll also turn that LED light on. So we're drawing down 183 watts or so. Not too bad. Everything's on and running. We're gonna go ahead and just pull the plug on the power supply, and that should act as a interruption in the power source, but it should not turn anything off. And it did not. It switched over immediately. Nothing blipped. Everything is still on down there. So it definitely is an uninterrupted power source. That is confirmed. So we're gonna let it run down a little bit here. It says we got about an hour, so an hour of use of running a television, a dehumidifier, a small cooler, a laptop, a diffuser, which the diffuser is working perfect, as you can see there. All that stuff will go for about an hour. And let's see if we're pulling down true hertz here. And we are. 60.2 hertz. It's amazing. So everything seems to be running fine. We're gonna go ahead and plug it back in, let it charge up, see if it picks up charging again. And again, we're running all of this stuff. All that's being run. And it picked right back up. So it says it'll charge in about 10 minutes. All right, we're gonna get everything unhooked since we confirmed that everything does work. All the power ports at once. We're gonna see what the maximum this little unit can take. They say it's 600 continuous, 1200 peak. We'll see. All right, we got a small ceramic heater. It says it's 400 watts. We're gonna go ahead and power it on. Now, if you know anything about these little heaters, they put a demand on inverters. So we'll see what happens. All right, we got it up to 360, no issues. It's running this heater on high. And it's also running this little dehumidifier stick. Now we're gonna see if we can bump it up some more. No issues at 360 though. All right, we're pulling over 400 watts now. The fan kicked on low, very low noise. And that's the big heater we're using. It's a big ceramic heater. So we're gonna keep going and see how far I can get. We're approaching 500 watts now. It's pretty good. All right, around 550 watts, the fan kicked on harder. So now it is making, you know, a decent noise, but still not bad. And it's still climbing. All right, we're at 595 watts output, 596, so right at what it says rated, and it's still going. We're gonna add some more loads to it. All right, we broke the 600 watt mark. We're gonna go ahead and amp it up now and see how far it can go. Wow, this thing is really putting out almost 700 watts now. We've got two ceramic heaters going. We're gonna break 700, yep, 701 watts. This thing's doing phenomenal right now. Oh, so 700 watts it shuts down. All right, we're just retesting. We're pulling 690, 695, no problem. Has not shut off yet, still going. All right, we're breaking the 700 mark again. We're gonna see how long it can hang out there for. All right, it shut down again. So it seems about 7 to 710 is where it's gonna shut down. Not bad at all. It's rated for 600 consistent or 1200 peak. So this is rated over spec. We're now gonna check out the solar panel and see how quickly it can charge it. All right, this is a 200 watt all powers flexible solar panel to give you an idea. It's about the size of 2.5 regular panels long. Depending on which way you mount it, it is flexible and it does have mounting hooks. Extremely nice ones, they're metal. And this is a flexible TPU type material, it seems. But we're gonna get it hooked up to the power station. This is at a good angle because this is our solar array. But we'll see how much sun this actually harvests. All right, we're super happy with the cable setup. They're split and insulated individually all the way down. Most of the times they're together, and when you separate them, there's a little line or something that happens there, but you get a fairly decent amount of cable on there. I mean, it's a good amount. So we're gonna plug it up and we're gonna see what happens. We got 60 watts so far. Sorry, trying to get a focus for you guys. It's sunny out. 108, 107 watts right now. And it's about 10:30 in the morning, so half of what it's rated at. All right, with overcast, about 50, 60 watts. So the sun's not coming through too well, but that's not the panel's fault. All right, guys, we are getting about 180 out. Sorry for the glare. But it was about 180 out of this 200 watt panel. So we'll come back and check it and try and catch that on camera again. All right, we're getting about 146, 147 watts. So that's pretty good. It's 2 o'clock in the afternoon. It's been cloudy all day today. So yeah, the solar panel is definitely doing its job. All right, upwards of 160 now. Again, clouds passing by. We're just trying to get close to that 200 to see if we put it out, 161. All right, 175 is what we're seeing. So solar panel's doing excellent, 175 out of 200. And it's holding strong at 175. 176, and it's 2 o'clock in the afternoon, so it's doing very well. All right, so here's our final thoughts on this setup here. The solar panel is way too big to be portable, so this is something that you're gonna wanna mount and leave in position, maybe on the top of a vehicle, maybe on a structure, like on a house or something, or on a mount, ground mount like that. But as far as portability, the solar panel is way too big. The box itself, highly portable box, you can go anywhere. You'll get several cell phone charges out of it. It'll charge a few portable batteries for cordless devices like Ryobi or Milwaukee and all that. It is 100% pure sine wave. We've seen that. It'll output on everything. It's not a large battery at 299 watt hours, but for the price and the warranty and the customer service, you cannot go wrong with this setup. So if you're looking for something to take to the job site to keep your phones charged and a couple batteries, perfect. Looking for something to go out camping with, excellent. Go to the beach, tailgating, so don't expect this thing to power anything for a long period of time, but it will definitely power one of the small refrigerators or coolers or something like that and keep you good for the whole day. So hope this helps. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe.